a new sci-fi thriller, a drama, and a horror flick are the newcomers in the box office. Our resident movie critic Manny the Movie Guy tells us his pick of the week.
That there is something underneath all of the isms that we experience in our lives across the world and across time.
Selma director Ava DuVernay returns with a moving study on race in Origin.
Happy birthday.
Based on the book Cast, The Origins of Our Discontents by Isabel Wilkerson, Origin is a biographical drama that shows how Wilkerson's personal tragedy catapults her into writing the book and uncovers the ugly truth about race in America. At times, the film sounds too academia, but have no fear. DuVernay honors the source material with a compelling narrative punctuated by indelible performances, specifically ingenue Alice Taylor as the author.
Trauma by ignoring it.
Origin challenges conventions, and that's a good thing.
I write answers.
And for that, Origin gets 3.5 out of 4, a very important movie. Kisses. Another film out in theaters is the slasher flick, Founder's Day. Mixed politics and psycho killers, and we get an intriguing horror whodunit. Founder's Day is a satirical political slasher about a series of ominous killings in a small town leading up to a mayoral election. Who's doing the killings?
Tricentennial.
From the Blomquist brothers, Founder's Day is fun and scary and pays homage to the genre. And for that, Founder's Day gets 3 out of 4 wickedly entertaining kisses. And finally, we have ISS.
The Russians always knock 3 times.
3 Americans and 3 Russians coexist in the International Space Station. So what happens when our countries clash down on Earth?
Oh my God.
The beauty of the film from director Gabriella Cowperthwaite is its mixture of authenticity and thrills. It's like watching a pressure cooker explode.
Houston, do you read?
And in the middle is Ariana DeBose. This is her follow-up film to her Oscar-winning role in West Side Story.
Because it was unlike anything I'd ever been given the opportunity to do.
Take a wild ride to outer space with ISS.
It's thrilling. Affecting. I mean, I clapped in the end. I enjoyed it.
And for that, ISS gets 3.5 out of 4. They can hear you scream in space. Kisses. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ABS-CBN News.
Now, a whole town rallying around an employee who is now out of the job. Quite understandable once you know the employee in question. Sergei, a gray cat with human-like eyes, had spent the past 3 years living inside the grocery after its previous owner passed away. He soon became a local celebrity thanks to multiple viral videos and appeared in several advertisements, a calendar shoot, even won Employee of the Year and got a personal manager. But Sergei's outstanding career may have to come to an end after an anonymous complaint was sent to the local department of Russia's Consumer Safety Watchdog. Local residents and tourists who noticed Sergei's absence are not giving up on him, though. They've started an online petition demanding his return. The campaign has over 6,000 signatures so far. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis drops out of the primary race in a relatively early exit, showing former U.S. President Donald Trump's iron grip on the Republican Party. DeSantis was once viewed as the Republican Party's best shot at moving past Trump. In early 2023, he led several head-to-head polls against the former U.S. president, but his support base has been declining for several months now, placing second in the Iowa caucuses.
Following our second place finish in Iowa, we've prayed and deliberated on the way forward. If there was anything I could do to produce a favorable outcome, more campaign stops, more interviews, I would do it. But I can't ask our supporters to volunteer their time and donate their resources if we don't have a clear path to victory. Accordingly, I am today suspending my campaign. I'm proud to have delivered on 100% of my promises, and I will not stop now. It's clear to me that a majority of Republican primary voters want to give Donald Trump another chance.
The end of DeSantis' bid means former U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations Nikki Haley is now the last Republican in the race.
And this comes down to, what do you want? Do you want more of the same, or do you want something new? Do you want to go back to a country where they decide who's a good person, who's a bad person, who's the right person, who's the wrong person? We've got 2 days until New Hampshire goes to the polls, but for now, I'll leave you with this. May the best win.
Well, as for Trump, he is celebrating the endorsement from DeSantis. Trump announced the development to his supporters during a campaign stop in New Hampshire, where the Florida governor's move was met with cheers.
We're going to have a big day in New Hampshire, I think equal to. And we just got some word that one of our opponents, a very capable person, is dropping out of the race, Ron DeSantis. And Ron is dropping out, and he, in doing so, he endorsed us.
The winner of this year's Republican nominating contest will take on U.S. President Joe Biden, the likely Democratic nominee in the general election come November. The Palestinian death toll in the Israel-Hamas war breaches 25,000. This as Israel pushes its southward offensive and resumes its bombardment of northern Gaza. Israel said its troops had cleared much of northern Gaza of the military network of Hamas, but fighting has continued in the Jabalia refugee camp and other areas around Gaza City. Gaza's health ministry said 178 Palestinians were killed in the past 24 hours, one of the deadliest days of the war. Heartbreaking and utterly unacceptable, that's how United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres describes the continuing deaths of civilians in Gaza. He also calls for the establishment of a Palestinian state to resolve the conflict, which Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu continues to oppose.
The Middle East is a tinderbox. We must do all we can to prevent conflict igniting across the region. And that starts with an immediate humanitarian ceasefire to relieve the suffering in Gaza, allow humanitarian aid to reach everyone in need, and facilitate the release of hostages, which should be immediate and unconditional. The denial of the right to statehood for the Palestinian people would indefinitely prolong a conflict that has become a major threat to global peace and security, exacerbate polarization, and embolden extremists everywhere.
Netanyahu rejects conditions presented by Hamas to end the war in Gaza. Netanyahu says Hamas is demanding the withdrawal of Israeli forces in Gaza and the release of Palestinian prisoners in Israel in exchange for the hostages. A deal in late November saw the release of more than 100 of the estimated 240 hostages taken by Hamas. The latest now on the war in Ukraine, at least 27 were killed in the Russian-occupied city of Donetsk. The city's Russian-controlled mayor said Ukrainian forces shelled a busy area where shops are located. There was no immediate comment from Ukraine. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky also did not address the shelling in his nightly video address, but he said in a single day, Russia had shelled more than 100 cities, towns, and villages in 9 regions of Ukraine.